Hello friends, good morning. And today we are doing the eighth session for module one of the course Analog Electronics. And today's focus of discussion is on MOSFETs. So let's see what are the learning objective for this lecture. This lecture, we will be introducing you to the field effect transistor devices, and we will also see the difference between FETs and the different types of transistor devices. That is, we'll be comparing the field effect transistors with the bipolar junction transistors, and we will also see how FETs and BJTs are different from or what is or why MOSFETs have become predominantly of usage compared to the FET devices or the BJT devices. Okay, so we will distinctively see the differences between all the three, and then we will also discuss the device structure of the N-channel enhancement type of MOSFET, and we will see what is the VI characteristics of this device. Okay, we will also see the characteristics as well as the current flow, okay, for this device. Okay, so these are the some of the learning objective for today's session. So let's begin our discussion on the field effect transistor. Okay, so field effect FET, as it is normally referred to as. Okay, so field effect transistor is normally abbreviated as FET, and it is another semiconductor device like the BJTs, which can be used as an amplifier or it can also be used as a switch. So like BJT, FET also is a three terminal device, and but the principle of operation of FET is completely different from that of a bipolar junction transistor. Okay, and the three terminals for the FET device is called as drain, source and gate. Okay, drain it is represented by D, and source is represented by S, and gate is represented by G, the usual notation that we use. Unlike for BJT, we call it as base, collector and the emitter terminal. Here we call the terminals as drain, source and gate. Okay, and if we have to highlight the features of FET, okay, some of the important features of field effect transistor devices are they are voltage controlled device, and it can perform amplification and as well as switching operation. Okay, BJT, when we discussed about BJT, the output current IC is controlled by the base current, right, IB, and hence BJT was referred to as a current control device. On the other hand, FET is a voltage, the voltage applied between the gate and the source, that is VGS, okay, controls the drain current ID. Okay, and therefore FET is a voltage controlled device. Okay, please keep in mind that BJT is a current control device and FET is a voltage control device. And why it is called as a voltage control device? Because the voltage applied between the gate and the source terminal controls the drain current ID, and therefore FET is a voltage control device. Okay, the name field effect. Okay, so you might be wondering why the name field effect is used here. Okay, so it is derived from the fact that the output current flow is controlled by the electric field set up in the device by the externally applied voltage between the gate and the source terminal. Okay, and that's why the name field effect. Okay, that is because the output current flow is controlled by the electric field that is set up in the device by the externally applied voltage between the gate and the source terminal. Okay, another important feature of FET is that it is a unipolar device. Okay, and FET is known as a unipolar device as the electrons and holes take part in the current conduction. We also saw in BJT, the electrons and holes take part in the conduction of current conduction. Okay, yeah, similarly here, it is known as a unipolar device as the electrons or holes. Okay. In BJT, it was called bipolar because both electrons and holes are taking part, okay, in the conduction. But here, the difference is it is a unipolar device. That is, either electrons or the holes take part in the conduction of the current or current conduction in the channel, okay. And like BJT, the parameters of FET are also temperature dependent, okay. So, we saw that whenever there is a change in temperature, even the VA characteristics or the current is drastically, there is a drift in the characteristics. Okay, we are not getting at the linearity. Okay, there is a drift in the small change also is affecting the voltage and current characteristics. Similarly, even if FET is affected or it is also dependent on the temperature. And in FET, a temperature increase increases the drain resistance. And also in when the temperature increases, the drain resistance also increases, and it also reduces the drain current. Unlike your BJT, the thermal runaway does not occur with FET. Okay, and thus we have to say that FET is more temperature stable compared to the BJT. Okay. That is because when temperature increases, the drain resistance also increases and reducing the drain current. And therefore, like how thermal runaway happens in case of BJT does not occur in case of your FET devices. And therefore, it gives more stable operation or more temperature stability is obtained with FET compared to the BJT. And conduction of the semiconductor channel is controlled by the electric field in the transverse direction. Okay, and let's see some more characteristics. Another important characteristics of FET is its high input impedance compared to BJT, and it is used in the design of AC amplifier systems. Okay, typically it is in the range of the resistance or high impedance or the impedance is in the range of 1 to several mega ohms. And because FET has high input impedance than BJT, they are preferred in amplifiers where high input impedance is required. Okay, and again, FET devices require less space compared to the BJT, and hence they are preferred in integrated circuits. Okay, and the FET devices or the field effect transistor devices are again classified into majorly two types. That is the junction field effect transistors, JFET devices. You call it as JFET devices. That is J stands for junction field effect transistor devices, and the metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistors. That is the MOSFETs. Okay, so M stands for metal, O stands for oxide, S stands for semiconductor. And FET stands for field effect transistor. Okay, so these are the two types of or how FET is categorized. Okay, so it is categorized as JFETs and MOSFETs. So JFETs again can be further classified into N channel JFET devices and P channel JFET devices. Okay, like how in case of your BJT, we had the NPN configuration and PNP configuration, right? The same way you can categorize the JFETs as N channel JFET or a P channel JFET. And MOSFETs again can be classified into depletion MOSFETs and enhancement MOSFETs. Okay, so in JFET, there is a direct connection between the gate terminal and the channel of the JFET. And in case of your MOSFET, the gate is insulated from the channel by a very thin layer of dielectric material, that is the silicon dioxide, SiO2. Okay, and thus, in case of your MOSFET, there is no direct electrical connection between the gate terminal and the channel. And due to this extra layer, the input resistance of the MOSFET is very, very high. Okay. So let's see what is the preferred technology, because we saw so many classification. You have JFET has two categories, and again MOSFET has two types. Okay, so out of them, which is the preferred technology and devices? Okay, so the enhancement mode of FETs or FETs are preferred compared to the depletion mode. Okay, why means because they're normally off devices, that is no channel between, there will not be any channel between the source and the drain. So when no voltage, that is because there is no voltage applied applied to the gate with respect to the substrate. Okay, that is when I say in case of when your the electrons enter the n channel through a terminal called source and leaves through the other terminal called the drain. So the terminal taken out from a heavily doped electrodes of a p-type material are called as the gates, and usually the electrodes are connected together and only one terminal is taken out, which is called as the gate. Okay, and this type of when heavily doped electrons on the p-type material form a p-n junction on the either side of the bar, and the thin region between the two p plates is called as the channel. And since this channel is in the n-type bar, the FET is known as the n-channel FET. Okay, and what do we call as an enhancement mode? Okay, or the enhancement mode is because they are preferred. I mean, they are more likely preferred devices, because in case of your depletion mode, okay, the construction is too highly doped N region are diffused into a lightly doped P substrate, and these two highly doped N region represent the source and the drain, and the source and drain terminal are again connected through a metallic contact to the N doped region linked by a N channel, and the gate is also connected to the metal contact surface but remains insulated from the N channel by very thin layer of dielectric material, which is again silicon dioxide, and thus there is no direct electrical connection between the gate terminal and the N and the channel of the MOSFET, which increases the input impedance of the device. Okay, so we will discuss in detail the structures of the device structure in the later slides. Okay, so be sure that in enhancement mode is preferred because they are normally off devices and no channel between the source and the drain, no voltage is applied to the gate with respect to the substrate. And depletion mode FET technologies would have been the natural choice for analog ICs because the devices are in the active region with zero DC bias. And as the enhancement mode FET technology is used mainly for digital ICs, the same technology is also used for analog ICs in view of higher reliability and yields. So use of a single technology for mixed signal for a mixed signal processing of the integrated IC. Okay. And when we are talking about the MOSFET design space, modern integrated circuits use MOSFETs extensively, or what is the reason for the extensive use of MOSFET devices compared to where BJT nearly ruled over 40 decades, and later now we have the MOSFET technology that is taking over the ICs. Okay, so the modern integrated circuit use MOSFET extensively because very high density of transistors, because of the very high density of transistors, which is going up to 10 power 9 transistor per centimeter square area in some of the ultra large scale system integrations and memory arrays. Okay, and again, the off-chip discrete resistors and capacitors are not commonly used. And on-chip resistors and capacitors generally are small, and multi-stage amplifiers are used are usually DC coupled. Okay, and so these are some of the reasons why it is extensively used. And transistors used wherever possible to implement current source. And these transistors are mostly preferred for the implementation of current sources, resistors, and capacitors. Okay. And now let's see the difference between the FET and BJT. Okay, so as I already mentioned in the earlier slide, in the earlier slides, that FET is a voltage control device, whereas BJT is a current control device. And FET, it has a very high we were discussing about the salient features of FET. Okay, we also mentioned that it has a high input impedance. Okay, so what is the impedance that impedance value that it can offer is anywhere between 1 mega ohm to several hundred mega ohms, whereas BJT has a low input impedance of few kilo ohms. Okay, and the third difference is they have FETs have a very good temperature stability. Okay, as I mentioned, and whereas BJT have a very very low temperature stability, and FET is a unipolar device, whereas BJT is a bipolar device. And FET, they are usually smaller in size, making them suitable for integrated circuits or IC designs. Whereas BJT, when we compare FET to BJT, BJTs are usually bigger in size. Okay, and then analysis of BJT amplifiers is comparatively difficult when you compare the same for an FET amplifier analysis. Okay, they are much easier compared to a BJT. And the drain current will be a function of gate to source voltage applied to the input circuit for an FET. And for BJT, the current collector current is a direct function of the level of base current. And the last difference is the current of the output circuit is controlled by the applied input voltage. And here in BJT, the input, the current of the output circuit is controlled by the applied input current. Okay, so that's why you call them as the BJTs are called as current control device, and FETs are called as the voltage control devices. Okay, so this is about the differences between the FET and BJT. And now let's see how they are classified and how these devices vary. The difference between the JFET and the MOSFET devices. What is the distinction or the difference that you have based on certain parameters like type, okay, or operation mode, input impedance, gate, or the channel, okay. When it comes to JFET, you have you can classify them into two categories. As I mentioned, you have the N channel and the P channel JFET, whereas MOSFET has four different varieties. That is, you have the N channel depletion type MOSFET, P channel depletion type MOSFET, N channel enhancement type MOSFET, and P channel enhancement type MOSFET. In the later slide, we will see the structure of N channel depletion type MOSFET. So the same principle is applied for the other modes also, okay. And then when we compare the operation mode, okay, the difference between the operation mode of JFET and MOSFET is JFET usually operates in the depletion mode, okay, and whereas MOSFET devices, they operate in the enhancement mode, okay. As I said in the previous slide, okay, the construction for a N-channel depletion type is what do you mean by in case of your depletion type? Okay, two highly doped N region are diffused into a lightly doped P-type substrate, and these two highly doped N region represent the source and the drain. The source and the drain terminal are again connected through a metallic contact to the N-doped region linked by an N channel, and the gate is also connected to the metal contact surface but remains insulated from the N channel by a very thin layer of dielectric material. And what is that electric material we use? It is the silicon dioxide. And thus, there will not be any direct electrical connection between the gate terminal and the channel of the MOSFET, which increases the input impedance of the device. Okay. So your input impedance for a JFET is very high, greater than 10 megahertz. And for MOSFET, it is very high, say, it is around, I mean, it is greater than 10,000 megahertz. Okay, so you can see why MOSFETs are more preferred from by the, I mean, more preferred compared to the JFET devices. Okay, and then when it comes to the gate, when we compare the parameter, gate parameter, for a JFET, the gate is not insulated from the channel. Whereas for a MOSFET devices, the gate is insulated from the channel by the layer of silicon dioxide. Okay, and then when we look at the channel parameter, JFET, the channel exists permanently in case of your JFET. Whereas in case of your MOSFET, the channel exists permanently in the depletion type MOSFET, but not in case of your enhancement type of MOSFET devices. Okay, that is the difference between the depletion and enhancement mode. Okay, where the channel will be permanent like your JFET device only for P-type devices or P-channel depletion type devices. The channel exists permanently in the depletion type MOSFETs, but in case of your enhancement type MOSFET, it is not permanent. Okay. So this is the difference between the JFET devices and the MOSFET devices. Okay, and again, depletion we refer as D MOSFET and enhancement as E MOSFET devices. Okay, so the basic operation is different for enhancement mode and depletion mode MOSFET. Okay. And let's see what is a MOSFET or what MOSFET stands for. Okay, MOSFET stands for metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. As I said, the abbreviation stands for metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor, and MOSFETs has normally we call it as a three terminal. The body is another terminal that is considered here. Okay, when you put it as a package, then it is a three pin device. Okay, so MOSFET has, why we call it as a four terminal, sometimes we refer it to as a four terminal because of the drain, gate, source and the body. Body is the terminal is connected internally with the source and source terminal, and thus the MOSFET package consists of three pins. Okay, and feature is it is a unipolar device and a voltage control device. So here we can see the symbolic representation of MOSFET device for the N channel MOSFET symbol, and this is the symbol in orange. Okay, so the orange diagram shows you that the symbol for N channel MOSFET, and the green here shows you the symbol of the P channel MOSFET. Okay. Yeah, and when we compare the applications of MOSFET with the BJT, in general, BJT and FET can be used for switching and linear amplification applications. And because of the low noise, FET devices, they are used in RF amplifiers and FM tuners and in communication equipments also. And since the input capacitance in FET is low, it is used in cascade amplifiers in measuring and testing equipment. And FETs are also used in mixer circuits in FM and TV receivers. And again, because of the low frequency drift, they are used in oscillators, and FETs are also used in low frequency amplifiers and also used in digital circuits. Okay. So looking at all the advantages that they have, okay, MOSFET has taken over, or say generally FET devices have taken over BJTs. Okay, so now let's see the device construction for the N-channel enhancement type of N-channel enhancement type of MOSFET. Okay, if we look at the construction of N-channel enhancement type of MOSFET, like depletion type MOSFETs only. Here we have two highly doped N region. Okay, so if you see, you have two highly doped N region that are diffused into a lightly doped P-type substrate. Okay, so if you see here, the P-type substrate and the N-type lightly doped P-type substrate and the highly doped N-type region. Okay, and the source and the drain are taken out through the metallic contact to the N-doped region, and the channel between the two N region is absent. Okay, so if you see here, the channel between, so this is called as a body. Okay, so you have the source, gate, drain, and the P type here. This is called as the body. Okay, the channel between the N region is absent in the enhancement type of MOSFETs. And the SiO2 layer is still present to isolate the gate metallic platform from the region between the drain and the source. But it is simply separated, okay, from the section of the P-type material. And it differs in the construction from that of depletion MOSFETs, okay. And if we look at the working of N-channel enhancement MOSFET on application of drain to source voltage VDS, okay, and keeping the gate to source voltage zero, and by directly connecting the gate terminal to the source terminal, practically zero current flows, and it's quite different from that of a depletion type of MOSFET or a JFET device. And if we increase the magnitude of VGS, that is the gate to source voltage, okay, in the positive direction, then the concentration of electrons near the SiO2 surface increases. So at a particular value of VGS, there is a measurable current flow between the drain and the source. And this value of VGS is called as the threshold voltage. Okay, so if we look at typically the channel length is around 0.03 micrometers, and the width is 0.1 micrometer. It can vary anywhere between 0.1 micrometer to 100 micrometers, and the oxide layer thickness is in the range of 1 to 10 nanometers. Okay, so this is about construction, and as I said, the channel is created by inverting the substrate surface from P-type to N-type, and the induced channel is called as the inversion channel. And the value of VGS at which a sufficient number of mobile electrons accumulate in the channel region to form a conducting channel is called as a threshold voltage, and it is denoted by VT, and it can range anywhere between 0.3 volts to 1 volt. Okay, so the excess VGS is termed as, okay, and again, a positive voltage above the threshold voltage induces a channel, and hence it is called as the drain current. And the conductivity of the channel is enhanced by increasing the gate to source voltage and thus pulling more electrons into the channel. And since the channel does not exist with when you set VGS to zero, and enhanced by the application of a positive gate to the source voltage, this type of a MOSFET is called as an enhancement type of MOSFET. Okay, I hope you understood. That is, when the gate voltage is above a threshold value, and it is induces a channel. Threshold value induces a channel, and hence the drain current is formed. And the conductivity of the channel is enhanced by increasing the gate to source voltage and thus pulling more electrons into the channel. And since the channel does not exist with VGS is equal to 0 volt, enhanced by the application of a positive gate to source voltage, this type of MOSFET is called as the enhancement type of MOSFET. And the excess VGS is termed as the effective voltage or the dry voltage, VOV. Okay, so this is how you create the channel current. Okay, so this is how you create the channel current in case of your MOSFET devices. Okay, so now let's move on to how you are creating the channel current. So we express, okay, the magnitude of the electron charge in the channel is expressed as, okay, so if you recall, the voltage across the parallel plate capacitance and that of the voltage across the oxide must exceed the threshold voltage V2 for the channel to form. And when VDS is equal to zero, the voltage at every point along the channel is going to be zero. And the voltage across the oxide, that is between the gate and the point along the channel, is uniform, and it is equal to VGS. Okay, so if the excess VGS over the threshold or VT is termed as the effective voltage, or it is also called as the overdrive voltage, right? And is a quantity that can be determined that determines the charge in the channel. Okay, and so we will denote VGS minus VT as VOV, right? Okay, where so that is what is represented here, VOV, and therefore the magnitude of electron charge in the channel is expressed as modulo Q is equal to COX into WL VOV. Okay, and where COX is called as the oxide capacitance and is the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor per unit gate area. It is given in the units of F by M square, where and W is the width of the channel and L is the length of the channel. Okay, I also told you what is the approximate length and typical L value and W value. Okay, and so the oxide capacitance is given by COX is equal to epsilon OX divided by TOX. Okay, where epsilon OX is nothing but the permittivity of the silicon dioxide, okay, which is given by 3. Approximately it is 3.45 into 10 power minus 11 and minus 11. Okay, and again TOX is the nothing but the oxide thickness, and it is determined by the process technology that is used to fabricate the MOSFETs. Okay, and approximately we assume TOX to be 4 into 10 power minus 9, that is 4 nanometers. Okay, and so your COX will be that is the oxide capacitance is now now calculated as 8.6 into 10 power minus 3 by m square, okay, farads per m square, meter square, okay, or m cube, I'm sorry, not m square, m to the power minus 3. Okay, so the total capacitance between the gate and the channel is C is equal to COX into WL. So substituting for COX and W and L, assuming W to be here. So W can vary from 0.1 to 100. L you are taking typically to be 0.03 micrometer. And so substituting these values, you get COX is equal to WL is 8.6 into 0.18 into 0.72, that is equal to 1.1 farads. Okay, so finally we note that VOV is increased, and the magnitude of the channel charge increases proportionately. Sometimes this is depleted as an increase in depth of the channel, that is the larger the overdrive voltage, the deeper is the channel. Okay, deeper is the channel. So the voltage VDS establishes an electric field E, across the length of the channel, and it is given by mod E is equal to VDS by L. Okay. So applying a small VDS, okay, that is you are having a induced channel, we can apply a positive VDS between the drain and the source. So here we first consider for a case of when VDS is very small, say around 50 millivolt, the voltage VDS causes the current to flow through an induced say n channel, okay, and the current is carried by the free electrons traveling from the source to the drain, and hence the name source and drain. So by convention, the direction of current flow is opposite to that of the flow of the negative charges. Thus the current in the channel ID will be from the drain to the source, and so we can calculate the value of ID. Okay, so and also we know that the voltage VDS is established by an electric field E across the length of the channel, and so it is VDS E is the mod E is equal to VDS by L. Okay, so the electric field in turn causes the channel electrons to drift towards the drain with the voltage with the velocity given by electron drift velocity is equal to mu n VDS by L. Okay, where mu n is the mobility of the electrons at the surface of the channel, and it is a physical parameter whose value depends on the fabrication process technology. And the value of ID can now be found by multiplying the charge per unit channel by the electron drift voltage. Okay, so the voltage VDS causes the current ID, and it is given by ID is equal to mu n C O X W by L into V O V into VDS. Okay, or you can also substituting V O V. How are we calculating V O V? By it is nothing but the difference between VGS minus VT, right? So I can rewrite this equation as mu n C O X W by L VGS minus VT into VD VDS. Okay, so the so the conductance can be found as, okay, so the conductance represented by G into GDS of the channel can be found as GDS is equal to, okay, so you can see the expression here, GDS is equal to mu n COX W by L VOX VOVE, or GDS is also equal to mu n. Okay, substituting for here VOVE, it can be rewritten as mu n COX W by L VGS minus VT. Okay, into VGS minus VT. Okay, I'm sorry. The MOSFET transconductance parameter KN parameter is KN, and KN is given as KN dash W by L. So if we observe the conductance, it is conductance is determined by the product of three factors. What are they? Mu N COX W by L and VOV. Okay, or it is equivalent to VGS minus VT. So in order to so we consider all the three factors in turn, and the first factor mu n COX is determined by the process technology and it is also used to fabricate the MOSFET, and it is the product of electron mobility mu n and the oxide capacitance COX. Okay, so and it makes the and it also makes the physical sense for the channel conductance to be proportional to each of the mu n and the COX. Okay, and hence they and hence to their product, which is termed as the process transconductance. Okay, you can also refer it to as the process transconductance, and this is given by a symbol KN dash. Okay, and so which is nothing but mu n into COX, And it can be also shown that mu n has the dimension of meter squared per volt seconds, and COx having the dimension of farads per meter square, and the dimension of Kn dash are amperes per volt whole square, okay, A by V square. Okay, so that, and again the second factor, okay, in is expressed for the conductance GDS, and is the transistor aspect ratio W by L. That is the channel current is proportional to the channel width W, and inversely proportional to the channel length L, and should make a perfect physical sense. So W by L ratio is obviously a dimensionless quantity that is determined by the device designers. And the values of W and L can be selected by the device designers to give the device the VI characteristics, required VI characteristics that is desired also. Okay. So for a given fabrication process, there is a minimum channel length. And in fact, the minimum channel length that is possible with a given fabrication process is used to characterize the process, and it is also being continuously reduced as the continuously reduces as technology advances. Okay, and for say for example, the state of art commercially available MOSFET technologies have a 32 nanometer process, means that for this process, the minimum channel length possible is 32 nanometer. And we should also note that the oxide thickness, that is a TOX value, okay, scales down to L min, okay, the for a 0.13, for a length of L, equal to 0.13 micrometer technology, the TOX that can be TOX is 2.7 nanometer, but for a current popular 65 nanometer technology, the TOX or the oxide thickness value that is used is approximately 2.2 nanometers. Okay, so the product of the process transconductance parameter KNI dash and the transistor aspect ratio is the MOSFET transconductance parameter, and it is given as KN is equal to mu Kn is equal to Kn dash W by L, right? So, what is Kn dash? I can represent as mu into COx into W by L amperes per volt square. Okay, so the MOSFET parameter Kn has the dimension A by V square. Yeah, the third para, the third term in the expression, okay, that we saw was GDS is the overdrive voltage, and this is hardly surprising since VDS, that is VGS minus VT, that it can also be equated to that, is directly determines the magnitude of the electron charge in the channel. And VOV is very important circuit design parameter. It's a very important circuit design parameter. Okay, so we will stop the session 8 here, and we will continue our discussion on the MOSFET characteristics, the transistor characteristics, in the next session. Thank you all for your patience.